I'm Dr. Nitin, and today we are going to see how to create reports which are typically forecast versus actual or budget versus actual. So there is a target and there is an achievement, and we want to see what is the variance. And all this we will do without using VLOOKUP or any manual formula. So let's get started. So this is my data. This is the actual transactions. Every row is something sold in each country. This goes on and on. And I also have the budget for each country. Have we exceeded the budget for each country or have we not? And that's the whole idea. Budget versus actual. Now, budget is just a word. It could be forecast versus actual or target versus actual. The important thing to understand is in the target or budget, there's only one number per country or per product. Whereas in the actual data, the same thing will repeat. So we need to sum this and then compare. Now, usually what most people will do, I try to do actually, it's not going to work, is put the VLOOKUP column here and take the budget from each country. That doesn't work. Let's not go into why it doesn't work. I'll tell you the best way. Why waste time? So the idea is, first we have to get this data into a data model. So the first step in all this is close the file and create a blank new Excel file. Why? Because we want to import the data into data model. Now, where is data model? Check if you are seeing this Power Pivot tab. If not, then go to the data menu and click on this green button which says Manage Data Model, or go to Power Pivot window. If you click for the first time, it will ask you, do you want to install? Just say yes. Now, this is a blank file. We go to Data, Get and Transform, Get Data from File. It is another Excel file, which is fine. And then we are using this file. Now, as you know, this file had two tables. So it's going to show you the sheets as well as tables. Never import sheets, always import data as tables. Now I want to import both, so I'm going to choose both of them. This will create two separate tables. Right now we are not going to think of data cleanup. I am assuming the data is clean, so I'm going to choose load. Now when we choose load, important to choose load to, because if you just say load by default, it may import it into Excel sheet. Here, only create connection. That means nothing is going to Excel sheet, and add to data model. Then click OK. So now it'll do whatever it's supposed to do and import the data. After it is done, nothing seems to have happened because it has gone into data model. How do you go to data model? Again, data tab, go to Power Pivot window, or Power Pivot, manage data model. In either case, it's going to open a separate window, and this window is where the data is. When you save the file, it is still an XLSX file. Not to worry. It looks like Excel sheets here. See, budget and transaction, but these are not sheets. These are Power Pivot data model. Now, what we really want to do is we want to say that this country is actually the same as this country. That is done by creating a relationship like we do in any database. So this is actually a database inside Excel. So go to diagram view and then it'll show you both the tables. All that you have to do is drag country from here to there. If you did it in either direction, it's the same thing. And now one to many relation is created. That's all we need to do here. Now we come back to our original Excel file. There is nothing in it. So we will now directly put a pivot table. Insert pivot table from data model. If it's an older version, you will still have this option in the original dialog. And I'll just put it here. Now, because we have data model, I can see both the tables here. So now I can say country, pick it up from the budget column. There is also same country in here, but I want to take this country. And then the amount is here. This is the actuals, right? And the budget I will pick up from here. But now this is good. Naturally, you will try to put a minus sign and put a formula outside. Don't do that. We should create that calculation inside the pivot table. And that's what you can do much better using the data model based pivot table. So it's a calculation. It's like a calculated field. So how do you calculate that? In data model based pivot table, if you go to calculated fields and items, that's disabled for a reason, because there is a better way available. Power Pivot tab, and then go to measures, and we will see new measure. Now you put it in any table, doesn't really matter. Measure name, we can call it difference, variance, whatever you want. I want budget minus actual, or actual minus budget, whatever you like. Now this is where you type the formula. What is the formula? You generally press square bracket, then you will understand what is available. Sum of amount and sum of budget. Okay. Or we know the table names also, right? So we have a table called transaction, and it's a better idea to say this. Sum of what? Transaction amount minus sum of what? Budget. In that budget. Budget table, budget column. Now always click on the check formula. There are no errors, and it'll create a diff column. And now you can see budget versus actual. And of course, this is not complete. Tomorrow, if more transactions come, what will happen? The original file will have more rows. All that you need to do is go to the data model and go to the data tab and say refresh all. As long as the path is same, it will refresh, and it will also refresh the pivot table. So that is how any target versus actual, forecast versus actual, budget versus actual is calculated using data model. I hope you found this useful. The sample file you can download from the description and use it to follow along. So that's it for now. Thank you.